ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this fantastic night known as UWC. The heat is on. All these weeks on UWC Online has led up to this moment here tonight, and you're going to see some fantastic action. You're going to witness a battle that's become personal between two guys who already met so much time in the past, but something's different about this one. Jason V and Jimmy Karryt. Thing about this match, not a regular match. No pinfalls, no submissions, no disqualification, no count out. I quit rules. The only way to win the match is to make your opponent utter the words, I quit. You're also going to see a fight for the United Wrestling Coalition Championship when Harker Dirge defends against the winner of the Championship Challenge Series, Blake Reed. And we know Dickie Wabash is going to be in Blake's corner. What's going to happen there? You're going to have to stay tuned and find out. We're also going to find out who's going to answer the open challenge to Rough Cut, the tag team champions. We're going to see the return of the money, Matt Cage, when he takes on Mark Vandy, and so much more, but I got to get out there and start doing my job. We got to get the heat is on underway. Sit back, relax, and enjoy. The heat is on.
Gentlemen, introducing the first.
Welcome to UWC Action. Eric Loy here, about to be joined by John Stone, and we are going to have some high flying to start this big UWC card. It's Joey O'Reilly going up against Tornado Jones. Two young men who like to fly around the ring. Two men who also, for the most part, stay on the right side of the rules when they're in the ring. See the veteran O'Reilly getting a early advantage on Jones. Roll through, kip up, and reversal. John Stone joins me up here in the booth, and this is going to be a battle between two folks who are not afraid to put their bodies in all sorts of strange positions.
Oh, exactly, and the one thing about these guys is they both love going up to those high places where nobody else can get to, utilizing moves that nobody else has even heard of.
And nobody else wants to try. Look at that, standing backwards, somersault and reversal. Now, whoop. Now, trying up and going up to the top rope.
Oh, look at that. Very nice. Over with the Rana.
And down goes Joey O'Reilly outside the ring. Is Jones going to follow him?
You better watch out.
And nope, catches himself.
And
O'Reilly using that veteran smarts that time. Trips him up on the ring apron, and Jones goes mask first.
Could have it. You know, it's very odd to say that Joey O'Reilly actually has the size factor in a match, but Joey O'Reilly is just a hair bigger than Tornado Jones.
And count after a nice suplex by O'Reilly. It is very rare that O'Reilly has that. And very rare that O'Reilly has the strength advantage.
Oh my gosh! The dragon twist right there!
Dragon Zord twist, I believe.
Dragon Zord, we'll go with that.
And now, chin lock, as the young man trying to figure out some way to get past the defense of Tornado Jones and inflict enough damage to get the three count. But both of these athletes will go up high. Again, a rare chance for maybe O'Reilly.
Oh, springboard dragon dagger back kick. Two.
And not a very good cover that time by O'Reilly. About his own shoulders down as much as his opponents. Nothing quick is going to work. This may be a situation where O'Reilly has to go to his rarely seen ground game.
Oh, exactly. And Tornado Jones, don't count him out. This man has been impressing a lot of officials in the back, a lot of people here at the Battle Zone, ever since the weeks and months that he's debuted here.
Yeah.
Oh, Japanese arm drag.
Goes up. Throws him in. Oh, just.
Oh, he's going to try.
On that second rope.
Try for the cyclone. Oh, and he hits it.
Partially blocked that time, but still O'Reilly is quite dazed still. Now coming up.
Oh my gosh, springboard face buster.
And a cover.
Could have it.
Nope, just a two. When you are a light heavyweight, as both of these athletes are, you really have to have the other athlete down. You're not going to get a whole lot of pressure on any sort of cradle attempt.
Exactly. Look, Joey's trying to get out of it there. Just a battle of wills here.
For an acid drop, switched into...
Oh, nice! Spinning pump kick!
Yep, Bill O'Reilly. Falling down, gets the cover.
Oh, he got it!
He got the three count. That was out of nowhere. Joey O'Reilly. That time it was the veteran coming up with the counter. And a chain wrestling ability of a veteran overcoming the young man.
Exactly. And as you said, out of nowhere, we weren't expecting something like that to happen.
Yeah. And you see Tornado Jones accepting. He's a new young man that will probably be in the ring again. Star-studded card has the return of Matt Cage. Money Matt Cage going up against Mr. Vandy. And I notice a very large bandage on the shoulder of Matt Cage. Vandy goes right after him right away. A knee and then a forearm to the back as he kicks in the corner. Cage is down quickly. I notice John Stone that Matt Cage comes in with a particularly large bandage on his shoulder.
Well, yeah, I believe Matt Cage actually suffered a little bit of a shoulder injury just a few months ago, so he's being protective with it. He's making sure nothing happens.
The problem with that is, as you're certainly telegraphing it to a wrestler.
Oh, exactly. It's almost like a shark that smells blood in the water.
Absolutely. Right now, Vandy's acting as if he smells a lot of blood, and he's been going after Cage from the get-go. Cage hasn't got any offensive back into the ring.
It's been a while since Matt Cage has actually been here, and he's matched up against the man who last week on UWC Online finally achieved victory here in the UWC when he defeated homicidal Steven Davis.
Of all things, to get his first win against Steven Davis. There you go, Matt Cage chop. And a second. Nope. Followed right away with a right hook, right to the mush. Andy up and drop. He's in control. Vandy. Now with a cover. Two. It's the two count. Vandy.
Matt Cage, of course, a former UWC Tag Team Champion multiple occasions.
Champion everywhere he's been. Been in several wrestling federations. Now into the corner. Vandy charge. Look at that.
Oh, look.
What a veteran move by Cage.
Nice. Two. Mark Vandy almost became 1-6.
Very quickly, man. Look at this. Small back off the ropes. That is the veteran.
Oh!
And wow, that is just force right there from Vandy and takes Cage right out. See, Cage can take a lot of punishment. We've seen him taking a lot of punishment wrestling larger individuals.
Oh, exactly.
And still, he'll pull something out. He's got a great deal of reserve to go along with ring generalship. Right now, he's got some birdies flying around his head after getting that knee.
You remember the last time Matt Cage was here was just about a year ago. He was involved in that vicious feud with his former tag team partner, Alex Castle.
He's almost out of here. He's got an 8. 9.
Oh, he's on 9.
Just gets in. Wow. That was close.
And here goes Vandy. Just exactly what he always does. He wants to cry and complain that he's not getting his way.
Yeah, he complains and he goes right at him, stomps and pounds the head of Matt Cage. Referee back got some there too. Now Vandy's a long, lean type of athlete.
Oh!
Inverted atomic drop.
Well, Vandy is long and lean. He's been here for a while, but it wasn't until last week where he was finally able to achieve victory, and now he keeps talking about, oh my gosh!
As a flying burrito forearm, and down goes Vandy. Now Cage hits up, he's ready to go.
Ever since Vandy got that one win here in this company, he's talking about wanting a shot at the championship. I think he's got a little more work to do before that.
Well, if he gets Matt spinning forearm off the top with a bolo type forearm, and Cage has got everything rolling his way, if he can somehow get a win over Matt Cage, that would propel him right towards the top immediately. Look at this.
Uh-oh. Swinging through there.
One, two, no.
Somehow Vandy finding the wherewithal to kick out at two.
If Vandy doesn't have the bodybuilder's physique, but he does have a lot of, you can say, the tendon strength. Raw bone type of individual. Oh, goes up. Oh, Lewis. He catches his man.
Look at the power on Vandy. Nobody's saying the man is not strong.
And a fall away Samoan. And look at this.
Oh, wait, look.
Oh, does not hook the ropes. Probably could have, but didn't.
Yeah, it looked like it for a second there he was going to hit the ropes.
Might have helped him out. Didn't need a whole lot of help keeping Cage down. But now walking away from Cage is a big mistake because Cage will find that reserve and strike out of anywhere.
Well, that's
he knows where the angles are at all times.
That's exactly what Mark Vandy's big mistakes are. Oh, my gosh.
Now it comes from behind. Into the rope. Throws him off that way. Cage rolls through. Does not catch him that time.
Swings.
Spinning right hand.
Shoves him into the rope. It's one of his own.
Well, good job by Vandy that time. Not, two and a half count.
Very nearly.
I was surprised Vandy was able to recover so quickly from that.
As I started to say earlier, when Mark Vandy actually started walking towards the ref and not paying attention to Cage, that's part of his problem. He thinks too much about himself, and he gets mad when stuff does not go his way, so he wants to start blaming the referee instead of taking advantage of the situation.
I think he shortened that time considerably so far. This is the high.
Oh, nice move right there.
Breaks the chin that time, goes for the roll cover.
Wait, look, his arms were under the ropes.
Two. No, foot on the ropes that time. Foot on the ropes.
Not
he might have reached over and got the hand on, but now Cage's going to get some support from the crowd. He's putting his knee pad down. That'll add a little bit of extra oomph from whatever he's got planned.
Cage is sitting himself.
Oh! Vandy just goes down. He just goes down. Cage is telling him to get up. Vandy's like, I can't.
I don't think he's going to be able to make it.
Down he goes again. What is going on here? The referee.
Must be some delayed reaction from that shot. Oh, my gosh.
And a quick roll up. One.
Wait a minute. Look, he's got the ropes.
And he's got the pin. Well, there you go. That might not have been all by Hoyle, but
Mark Vandy just got himself to 2-5 here.
Here's your winner,
and that's a big two. Matt Cage just got himself outwitted that time.
Exactly. Look at Cage. He's arguing with the referee, and he has a decent right to. I can't believe I just saw that.
Well, I got to give Vandy credit. He outwitted a fellow who I think is among the top 5% smartest wrestlers in the area, and he just outwitted him to get the win. That's got to put something in. That's going to move him up the ladder in a hurry.
this is supposed to be. You laugh, you dance, you carry on in gallivant without a care in the world. Some of us can no longer sit by and let the fun continue. You see, it's people like you and people like that joke Travis Weir in the back. Somebody who had so many high expectations. Somebody who went from being the Horizon Cup champion to nothing more than a dancing, foolish Neanderthal.
See the best page at the best. What he is going after Travis Weir now. The ring jacket or gi that he came to the ring with, using him to choke him out. John Stone, this. I haven't been here for a couple of weeks. What has been going on with this young man? And it's possible that he even got hotter.
It started happening just a few months ago. I mean, the man that I guess was known as Phage, at first he turned on Tornado Jones and Travis Weir after a triple threat match.
I remember that.
And he started to act like, oh my God, look at this! Very nice! Big stupid elbow! But Phage started to act like the voices in his head were taking over. But then there was a point where we thought Phage finally grasped reality and he was back to being his normal self. Then he disappears for God knows how long, a few weeks, and he comes back like this.
Sometimes people shouldn't be their normal selves.
He singles out Travis Weir here tonight, the same man that he's been warring with over the past couple of months.
Well, Weir came out, and now we've got ourselves a match. And I guess we'll still call the young man Phage, but...
Ooh!
And that, just a young man got caught in between the top and middle rope, and Weir is down. How do you wrestle against or fight, I guess in this case, a person who may have multiple personalities to go from?
How do you just talk to the man, let alone wrestle? I mean, you can't carry a conversation with the man. You can't wrestle the man.
Whoa, look at this, a pressure hold on the shoulder.
You can't even be in the same room with him. You don't know who you're talking to half the time.
Sometimes you're in the same room with many of them.
He's in the same room with himself.
I'm not really sure about that, but right now, a pressure point on the shoulder of Weir.
Travis Weir, of course, the 2013 Horizon Cup tournament winner.
That was referenced by Phage. Headbutts. Handle right to the head sends Weir down. That was referenced in that bizarre rambling rant at the beginning of this match.
Oh, exactly. And touch on the fact that Travis Weir said, I've lost too many people this year already. And of course, it's got to be touching home with the fact that his best friend, I guess, or former best friend, Blake Reed, completely turned on him a couple of months ago and joined up with the Wabash Talent Agency. Blake Reed, we're going to see him here in just a little bit fighting for the championship. But
well, he's got a double whammy there. Not only has he turned on him, but obviously turned on him towards successful waters as he's getting a shot at the championship. And to Phage's point, here's Travis Weir. Not exactly been the most successful athlete since he won that Horizon.
Yeah, could that, it's an arguing factor, but could that be a plot point to say, ever since he won it, and the downward spiral is
happening? There it is.
Oh, got it locked on!
Got it straight on the frontal lobe. Well, broke it off.
Of course, Travis Weir, normally when he comes out here, he's happy-go-lucky, he's dancing around with the fans, but there was no dancing here tonight.
Different tack on the same type of claw maneuver. looks like he's not really using it so much as a submission, but as a wearing down type of hold.
Almost as if to say kneel before Zod, wouldn't you say so?
Kneel before face.
There's a Superman reference for you.
Yes. Off the rope.
Uh-oh.
Big man.
Ooh, nice.
He's into the ref.
Uh-oh, referee down.
Oh, just destroys him with that. Referee is not...
With the ref, did he knock his glasses off? Or...
Knocked his block off.
No, his glasses. He was searching around for his glasses.
And that's why referees should always have the goggle-type glasses. Now Travis Weir. Going for that king with the bunny mask.
Oh, wait a second. Boom!
Bang, right on the back.
The bunny mask. We've seen that bunny mask before. Another one of his personas. Oxy Cottontail, many months ago. Oh, my gosh.
Oh, that was terrible.
The ref didn't have his glasses on at the time.
Three, and he got the pinfall. Well... Whatever voice he listened to that time.
Here's your winner, the Warden.
The Warden. The chaos is here.
The Warden?
What was Phage is now the Warden. I guess the voices in his head have taken over completely.
Well, I think a lot of people are going to have to take a close look at what this Warden is trying to bring to the ring. But there may be more than one man in that head. Oh, he makes some good points. We'll be back with more action.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall, and it's for the United Wrestling Coalition Championship. When the bell rings, he's in charge, UWC official, Mr. Shawn Rife. Introducing first, the challenger, accompanied to the ring tonight by Kiki Wabash. From Chicago, Illinois, weighing in at 320 pounds, representing the Wabash Talent Agency, he is your number one contender, the notorious Malliki. And ladies and gentlemen,
championship action as Harker, Dirge, the UWC heavyweight champion, takes on the notorious Blake Reed, along with Dicky Wabash, who, by the way, must compliment Mr. Wabash on his attire. And the two lock up through the powerhouses in the UWC, and it's quickly Harker, Dirge, in the headlock, working on Big Blake Reed, now off the ropes. Reed throws him off, shoulder block. No one going anywhere on that one. Now, whoop.
Oh, wait.
Wabash tries to get into it. Now he's going to get out of it.
Oh, I hope he gets his hands on him. We saw what happened a few weeks ago when it was Harker versus Dickey. Put Dickey out for a few weeks, and it was a great few weeks.
Well, he just goes and hides. But by that time, Dirge comes in, and Reed is all over him, choking him on that second rope. I have to give... Mr. Wabash, some credit. A little bit of sartorial splendor today. A tie and coat.
Well, it's about time he started wearing more than just a vest.
And there's nothing wrong with that.
Of course, this match came about because Blake Reed was the winner of the championship series, which took place over a couple of weeks. Of course, that it ended up in a tag team match, himself and his talent agency partner, Cecil Cerveza, against the two men we're going to see later on, Jason V and Jimmy Karryt. Cecil Cerveza not very happy. If you look at the way Cecil Cerveza is looking at things, he thought he was going to have his rematch against Harker Dirge to get back what he still thinks is his UWC championship. But his own manager signed the contract in the wrong place, and Dickie is the one that got that match. Then when he had another opportunity to win the Championship Challenge Series, his tag partner wins the match. So you gotta be looking at things from Cecil Cerveza wondering why this stuff keeps happening to him.
Well, that is true, but also, Cerveza has to remember that it was the direction of Wabash that got him the title in the first place. So he may have to wait again. A lot of athletes in the UWC, and they're covered by Reed gets the two. There are a lot of athletes in the UWC who are in line for a shot at Harker Dirge's championship. Just because you've won the championship before doesn't mean you automatically get another shot.
And I know a lot of people are saying that in this type of situation, Harker Dirge isn't going to have a problem. Harker Dirge is just going to be able to run through Blake Reed. But let's not forget, on the most recent edition, UWC Online, it was a tag team situation. Harker Dirge was teaming with Aaron Matthews against Blake Reed and Cecil Cerveza. And who was it that got the pin in that match? Blake Reed. Who was it that he pinned? Harker Dirge.
Well, that has got to be certainly.
Oh!
Well, first of all, it's a huge upset. Look at this.
Oh, nice.
But it has to hearten Blake. Straight down with a slam.
Wait a minute, new champion?
No, you've got to put the pressure down.
Well, it's got to strengthen Blake Reed's chances, but what's going through Harker Dirge's mind knowing just 1 week ago I lost to this man?
You might be able to sneak Harker Dirge in a win against him, but you're not going to be able to do it twice. He's got himself focused now. He knows exactly what Reed brings to the table. But remembering that, you don't have to kill the man to win. All you need to win is 3 seconds. And that has happened to Dirge as it did last week. Now,
and of course, that's the pivotal thing right there in these title matches. The champion doesn't have to beat the challenger.
No.
The challenger has to beat the champion.
Yes. You see an interesting version of a bear hug here where it's almost like a
backbreaker bear hug?
No, it's kind of like trying to get food out of his throat.
Oh, the Heimlich maneuver. That's what you're thinking.
We'll call it the Heimlich maneuver hold. But
oh!
Now he's going to need it because Harker Dirge just put a beating on him. He doesn't want to swallow. Now a left jab, a right hook. Another right hook by Dirge into the rope. Coming off of it, meets the boot. This is not what Reed wanted. He does not want Dirge to get any momentum whatsoever.
Uh-oh, incoming! You know, we've already seen Dickie Wabash get involved once in this match, but you gotta remember, anytime you're in a match with a Wabash Talent Agency member, it's never one-on-one.
Oh no, absolutely not. The big guy still doesn't go down with this reversal into the corner. Now here comes the train. Ouch.
You remember back, wait a minute.
One, two. Oh no.
Very
rolled out. Just rolled out.
Very nearly. Blake Reed could have called himself UWC champion again. He's held that title multiple times in the past.
Not in the recent past.
Oh no, it's been a while. It has been a while, I will give you that. Don't forget, back at Domestic Disturbance, Blake Reed was actually put through a table by Harker Dirge in the TLC match.
Charging again, this time using his momentum against him as the boot by Dirge.
Oh, knocks him down, but look at Dickie Wabash on the outside. He's got a chair.
Yeah, he's got a chair, and what else has he got?
He's got the belt. Are you kidding me?
Yeah, he's trying to distract Dirge. Trying to distract Dirge.
No, he's doing a good job of distracting the referee right now. That chair is still sitting in the ring.
Now.
Oh, no.
Reed's got it. Dirge has got to watch out.
Oh, no. Watch out!
Oh, no, caught it that time. Kick. And DDT straight into the chair. That chair is gone.
It went against him.
One, two, good night.
He got it. And you can clearly say it was Dickie Wabash that lost the match for his charge right here.
Dickie Wabash missed the chance to become a two-time manager of the WWE champion. It's strictly a move that backfired coming directly from the mind of Dickie Wabash.
Well, I'll tell you right now, with the mindset that Cecil Cerveza is already in, the anger that he's got, and now Blake Reed, when he watches the video back and sees what happened, I wouldn't want to be Dickie Wabash right now.
I wouldn't want to be Dickie Wabash anyway.
Well, that's true.
But your champion is still Harker Dirge. We've got a lot more action coming up from the UWC. Stay tuned. Back in a moment.
Got three teams in here, six men in the ring, not counting the referee.
Yeah. Well, I think Rough Cut doesn't care.
Oh!
Hits him. Now they hit nobody. They're getting hit. They're getting bounced in between the two teams.
It's official. The bell was rung.
And now Rough Cut sends one team behind and gets nailed by the other.
The chance builds to the outside. There goes Frank Wyatt, Spencer Wallace, the first team to accept the challenge. JJ Garrett, Malliki Matthews left alone in the ring.
Well, that's not going to help him being in the ring. They still have to pin somebody. Garrett and Matthews.
Wait a second.
Going up to the top. Look at this.
Oh, no. Watch out.
Oh. They both come down, and down goes everybody.
Down. Wyatt and Wallace are down.
And there goes Spencer back into the ring.
Referee Mike Underwood gonna have to get a handle on the situation right now.
Chip, down he goes.
Wait a minute, look at this. Oh!
One, two, no.
Well, it was a good tag team maneuver.
Well, it's not really sure who gets... If he got that pin, would they be champions?
I believe so. I mean, they didn't specify whether this was elimination or a single fall.
Whoop. Up and over, not quite out. Wallace gets a block that time.
Wait, look, on the outside. Oh!
Nice. Two, no. Well, it looks like it is. Anybody who gets the pin gets the win because Rough Cut came in to try and break that up. Normally, they wouldn't care less.
Exactly. That was a nice slingshot corkscrew body press there.
Now, this is a very bad situation for Rough Cut. He basically got two teams wrestling for their championship, and they're not even in the ring.
Exactly. They don't even have to be pinned to lose.
And a little tag team coordination there.
I think they bit off a little more than they can chew here tonight.
Even big.
Oh!
Just rolls him over.
That's 360 plus pounds.
Two. Bruce Sawyer comes in to try and break that up, but
I think the last time that Frank Wyatt was on a scale, it measured in at about 368.
And then it died.
Oh yeah.
Uppercut. And Wyatt gets him in the corner, tagged to Wallace. Last time I saw Wallace a couple weeks ago, he had a pretty good match against Jason B.
That he did, and it earned him a Facebook like.
Yeah. You see the young man maybe taking it just a little bit more seriously.
Oh.
But you always have a chance if you're in the ring with somebody like Wyatt as a partner.
Oh, blind tag there.
Here comes. Now that time, Steele comes in. There's not going to be any pin attempt. Now Steele's going to try the pin. Referee not paying attention.
He's trying to get Garrett out of the ring.
And just a one count that time. Had about a five count.
Garrett had no idea that the tag was made.
This is a very strange dynamic here between the three teams. Steele and Sawyer certainly have come together as a tag team since they've formed. You know, Sawyer was not overly happy with this tag team when they first got together. They've been nothing but victorious since.
They've been having their problems with Bradley Dupree. I gotta say it that way. It's hard to say. It's hard to say this guy's a lawyer because I've never seen any credentials.
Again, under advice of my attorney, I cannot say anything about Mr. Dupree.
Frank Wyatt breaking up the pin attempt there.
Now Wyatt knocked back out.
I said it earlier and I'll say it again. You got to believe that when Rough Cut made this open challenge, they weren't expecting two teams to accept.
Well, yeah, they're certainly working on Wallace. Wallace. He's got to stay alive right now. He doesn't need to get a whole lot of offense in. He needs to stay alive, get out of the ring.
Of course, we know that Spencer Wallace's friends over at SSC Services in Mattoon, Illinois are watching right now, hoping that their young friends can pull out the victory and walk away a tag team champion.
He's got that on his trunks.
Oh, yeah, SSC Services, Mattoon, Illinois.
Yeah.
Josh Steele got Wallace in the corner now.
Suplex possible. Yeah, Wallace driving him back. Trying to get a tag team. They're tagging. Now a blind tag the other way this time. Steele's got to get out of there.
Answering back like earlier. Here
now
comes Malliki.
Tagging to Malliki. Now it's going to be very tough for any team to really get a momentum going. You can be tagged in blindly by a team that's completely fresh.
One person that's not fresh right now is Spencer Wallace. He's just getting the digits beaten out of him.
Yeah, but again, all he has to do now is stay alive. Don't get pinned. Get out of there. He's got to remember, he doesn't even have to tag his own man.
Bo Sawyer, first one to break it up.
Doesn't have to tag his own man. He just tags anybody, and he can get out of that ring, and his team can freshen up. That's a tough thing to remember when you're used to 2-on-2.
Oh!
Ouch.
That was almost a full body hit.
That'll give you some whiplash in a hurry. Two. Steele coming in, and Malachi's going to go after him.
Mike Underwood's getting a workout here.
And a tag in now. Nice kick to the side, the non-advertising side.
Here comes Garrett coming in.
Garrett noticed that he had to look back and make sure that Wyatt didn't get a hold of him.
Well, that's the problem. The only really neutral free corner you can get in right now already had Spencer Wallace in it. You've got guys at each other corner.
That's right. Now Wallace is in the worst possible situation for him. He's far away from anybody to tag.
Every time Spencer gains a little bit of momentum, someone's there to cut him off.
Yeah. Impressed with Matthews. He's got a good skill set there.
Oh, exactly. I mean, Matthews, it's been a while since he's been here, but he's always been impressive.
Whoa, look at that.
Oh, very nice move.
Tag the big man.
Just spins him down.
NFL camps have just opened.
Wait a minute, here comes Steele.
And Bo comes in.
Big Bo, power, and Steele sends him down.
And Bo Sawyer goes down, and you've got to be a truck to do that.
Wyatt keeps this up, we may see new tag team champions before the end of the night.
We may see a couple of ambulances if this keeps up.
Three scoop slams in a row.
Now Big Bo, and up, and down. Oh, look at this, there we
go. Wait a minute, it goes up.
Nope.
To the floor. Smart move on the part of YBBO.
Yep, nice. Good double team maneuver that time.
That was a flatliner Inzaghi combination.
I don't have any idea who's legal right now.
Oh, we've lost control here.
Right into Wyatt on the outside. The champions.
Wait a minute, here comes the Graven! The Graven!
And again, good night.
And the champs did it!
Taking advantage of the chaos. That was made them a long time champion. And even in the situation where the odds stacked against them, they've been able to come out on top.
Cecil challenge match. Introducing first of company tonight by Dickie Wabash.
And Cecil Cerveza. Two wrestlers who certainly are no strangers to each other in the ring. Cecil Cerveza. Whoa. Fit right in the eye of Aaron Matthews. Matthews wrestles with a fist drop kick in Illinois. And here we go. We've got action. Matthews coming at Cerveza, flying forearm in the corner. And right back up. Punches lights out in the corner. I see Mr. Wabash is a little more disheveled after that first match.
But wouldn't you be? I mean, who knows what happened backstage with Blake Reed?
We'll have to see if we can get some information on that a little bit later on. Into the corner goes Cerveza. Matthews comes in. Monkey out of the corner. That's some old school.
Of course, this is a challenge match here. It's actually a rematch from a couple of weeks ago. Main event of UWC Online from a few weeks ago in the first round of the championship series. Cesar Cerveza, although he did defeat Aaron Matthews that night, it was very controversially.
Oh, that's flying forearm and a cover. That won't do it.
Cecil was also incredibly jealous that 2 weeks ago it was Aaron that was given a special shot at Harker Dirge in the UWC title on an episode of UWC Online. And he's become increasingly jealous over all the success that Aaron Matthews has been having over the last few months.
Cecil Cerveza finally conquered that mountain. Able to stay on top, up and over, a flare flip over the top rope.
Right, climbing to the top.
Now trying to, unfortunately, he's ended up in the same situation Ric Flair used to. Gets caught.
Aaron trying to fight him off. Oh!
Thrown off that top rope and down to the floor goes Cerveza.
Oh, not just down to the floor, face first to the floor.
Cerveza had been wrestling with an anger, but a focused anger. And now that seems to have gone by the wayside. Once he finally achieved getting to the top of the business in the area, the consistency, the lack of consistency that has plagued him. Come back.
Watch out!
Ooh! And the boogie comes down to the front row.
Yeah. All fans better watch themselves. Incoming!
And Matthews comes outside. And the first flurry of offense has gone to Aaron Matthews. Cerveza needs to take it to the mat. Ground the aerodynamic wrestler. That won't do it.
Oh my gosh.
Ouch.
Very nice. Face first into the mat.
And a quick cover. That could have been three. That could have been three.
What would it do to Dickie Wabash if tonight both of his men were to end up on the losing end?
Oh, no. Caught him that time.
Oh!
Off that top. Turnbuckle. Now setting him up for something. Maybe that knee in the corner.
Comes out of it. Running STO.
Yeah. Didn't quite catch him the way he wanted, but still caught him. And a quick cover. That won't do it. He had his foot on the ropes. And there we go. That's that aggression. Still not with the effort and heart that he had before.
Oh, now just choking him with that foot. Wait a minute. Look at Dickie on the outside. He called him over for something.
Yeah. Brought him over the side rope.
Oh, God.
So Wabash just compensates and pops him right on the side of the head.
Just like I said earlier, Dickie Wabash always gets involved, and it's never a one-on-one situation.
Now, working that neck and a bumper back area. If I was Wabash, I'd be worried about the calm of Cerveza at this point.
Almost looks like some teeth spit out of Aaron Matthews' mouth. I couldn't tell.
I don't know. Gonna drag him back out here, looks like, to try to. Matthews trying to hang on, climbs up to that top rope.
Oh, no. Ooh!
Onto the knees. Now that's a brilliant move.
Oh, my God.
Cover by Cerveza. He knew that wasn't gonna go.
That's definitely gonna cause some back pain.
And now to an arm bar. Well done, going to place a lot of torque on the elbow and shoulder. Now, keeping him on the mat. This is a smart move. And as soon as I say that, he brings him right up.
Bounce off the rope, stuck underneath the clothesline attempt there. Body wrap into a scissors, roll through. Oh, man!
Don't even know what to call that, but it ended up in a cover.
Heard a piranha. Almost a tornado bulldog.
Problem though, Badger's on a bull. Say hello to my little friend.
Oh! Thrusting super kick, sends her to the floor.
And outside, now Cerveza needs to get his act together while in there. Didn't seem like he had much of a plan going in. And you notice on it, if you look at the matches with Cerveza earlier this year, was on the winning end up to the title, he had a concentration on him, an anger, but a concentrated anger. Now it's more of a disappointment.
Somewhat. I think, honestly, I believe it's all the things that's happened to him over the last few weeks is messing with the man's psyche. And it's almost putting him back in that old state of mind that he was in before he won the title. Before he turned on Jason V.
There's an old saying in boxing, it's called sparring partner syndrome, where you get used to losing, used to getting beat up. And frankly, having known Cecil Cerveza for a long time, I'd hate to see him go back to that, because what was bringing him success got him to the top. There he goes. Up Matthews with a slam.
If anything, he should have more of a fire lit underneath him. He had a little taste of glory with that title. The taste of it should make him want more.
Absolutely. And he knows what got him there. Again, working on that neck of Aaron Matthews. Aaron Matthews, always a big fan favorite here in Georgetown.
Oh! Well, Eric Loy, I'm actually getting called to the back real quick. I got to take care of some business back there. I'm going to leave you here to take care of this.
All right.
I'll be back in just a little bit.
All right. We'll do our best at flying knee by Cerveza. Coming up, another knee off the ropes. Now working quickly in chain. German suplex. Going to go for the cover. Two. Kick out. This is good move. This is good stuff from Cerveza. Taking a little bit too much time now. Folks, we know the type of athlete that Aaron Matthews is. We know he can take a lot of punishment. Rolling the dice. I think Matthews is trying to block. Nope. Matthews got out of it. Reversal back to Cerveza into the ropes. Trying to roll him up. Does so. Hangs on. Two. No. Brings it right back up, does Matthews. Dragon sleeper. Tries into a suplex. That's right down goes Matthews. Chain and counter chain that time. And both athletes down. These two have faced each other often, have been tag team partners on occasion. over many, many years. There isn't a whole lot of surprise between the two. That's why you can see so many blocks and counters. Counter right hand with a right hand. Elbow that time, right hand. Elbow smash, right hand. To the gut, face. Now up and down. Cerveza takes care of that with an inverted atomic drop up the ropes. And just glance him in the mat. And that could be it for Matthews. Roll up, one, two, no. No, the shoulder closest to Cerveza. Too much room to roll up. Cerveza calling for the knee. He needs to stop calling for it. Give Matthews too much time. He'll come up with a counter, and he does. Into the corner, and a foot by Matthews coming off the ropes. A canister. And a cover. Just a two. That's not going to get Cerveza. Someone who hasn't had a whole lot to do with this match for a while is Dickie Wadosh. Now, Cerveza outside the ring. Matthews coming in, gets caught with the boot, and he's strung out on that second rope. Going to suplex him out? Yes! Oh, ow! On the outside, you can hear the scream of Aaron Matthews, and he took it straight back to, well, this floor. And now they're coming out to take a look at Matthews and make sure he's all right. Matthews says, get out of here. Count of four. Cerveza tells him, stay down. The Georgetown faithful yelling for their man to get up. Matthews up to eight. Reaching for the camera person, that's not going to happen. It just rolls in. Just rolls in. At 10. Just rolls in. The match continues, but there can't be a lot left of Aaron Matthews. Cerveza's got to stay on him. He's let too much time go by. He's got to keep on his man. Matthews can pull victory out of nowhere. And now, pops him on top of the head. Misses that time. Spin. Driver. One, two. Oh. That was very well done by Cerveza, and I can understand some frustration right now. But again, Matthews isn't the biggest wrestler, but there's a lot of heart in that frame. Cerveza's taking its time, trying to figure out a way to finally get that last count on Matthews. Begin. Keep an eye on Matthews. Misses that time, comes off, misses the elbow. Tries the Fez press, but that's not going to work. Slingshots him up over the top rope, and hanging on is Matthews. Matthews is hanging on, up off the top rope. And again, runs into it. Neither one of these wrestlers can have a lot left. Hung out to dry on that second rope. Matthews pops him on the outside. Matthews climbing to the top. Cerveza struggling in the middle of the ring. Comes cross body block. One, two, and no. Didn't hook the leg. Matthews going to try something else now. You know this Aaron Matthews is a maniac for these heights. Looks like Cerveza's ready. No one there. No one there. Whoa, misses the big kick. Matthews tries to catch him now. Throws him off the rope to Cerveza. And nails the kick that time. Right to the side of the head. That could be all. Rolls him up. Here's the count. One, two. That's a two. That was millimeters. He was able to get his shoulder up by millimeters. Trying to finish this off. Got him in. Could be a roll of dice here. No! Snapmare out of it. Matthews thrown over the top, but hanging on again is Matthews. What is this here? Oh. They'll try to drag him back into the ring. Reverse back up and over. Miss. Second rope, top rope. Nails him. Got him. Two. Three. And Matthews doesn't even know. Matthews doesn't even know what happened. Cerveza and Wabash have just lost it in the ring. Matthews. Aaron Matthews gets the ring and he doesn't even know he won. Aaron Matthews can bring it out of absolutely nowhere, and that's why if you don't get him and keep him down, he will always find a way to put you back to the mat for the three count. And move off the top rope. Nicky Wabash's company is 0-2. Very unhappy season for Cerveza in the ring right now. It wasn't the effort for Cerveza or quit pounding the ring out. It's a tantrum by Cerveza. It wasn't his effort. Sometimes you just get beaten. We have got a heck of a finale coming up, folks.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is your main event of the evening and will be fought under I Quit rules. The rules state there are no pitfalls, no submissions, no disqualifications, no countouts. The only way to achieve victory is by making your opponent utter the words, I Quit. Introducing first, weighing tonight at 185 pounds, now known as the Powder Keg, this is Jimmy Garrett. And introducing his opponent, from
Jason B. and the Powder Keg. Jimmy Karryt, who we know, an I Quit match. Roll straight down, kicked off. Rolled into the corner. Get those taped fists now, get a little extra advantage. B trying to cover up, but now no chance of covering up right now. As Karryt in and a couple of knees for his trouble. And into the corner. Coming back again. Maybe a third time. Comes B and the elbow lands again. And Garrett is down on the mat.
This is the most personal match I think these two in their long and storied career are facing off with each other.
They've had a lot of personal matches.
Oh, exactly. But this one, I think, trumps them all. He's going for the boot early on.
Well, now, that might get you a pinfall. Is it going to get you an I Quit? If a guy's knocked out, you can't say I Quit.
Don't forget, over the past few weeks, Jason V has actually landed that boot right into the face of Jimmy Karryt on multiple occasions, even one time busting open the man's mouth. I was in the room when Jimmy Karryt was spitting blow. Oh my gosh.
And we've got a fire extinguisher and a
kendo stick.
Yeah.
Oh no. Ooh.
And that fire extinguisher works good for putting out your opponent's fire.
Of course, sourdough on the outside. Some can argue that sourdough is the root of this problem between all three of these men.
And again, it's not a big fire extinguisher.
Oh.
Certainly a good enough weapon to be able to use frequently. We're trying to turn it on.
It's like, oh, he kicked it out of his hands.
And over the top goes Karryt.
I started to say sourdough could be charged as the man that's the root of the problem here, because it was sourdough and Jimmy Karryt that were feuding originally that caused Jason V to get himself involved.
Well, I know, known all of these athletes for a while. And I know that the kind of person that Jason V is, but sooner or later, Sourdough's got to stand on his own feet.
Well, the one thing I can say is Sourdough appears to... Oh, my God!
Wow!
That might be the barrier holder, but there's nothing but solid concrete inside that bucket.
He got a kick, and now, coming outside, and you warned him before the match.
Exactly.
This is not a falls count anywhere match. Falls do not count anywhere.
There are no falls.
Falls do not matter.
As I started to say earlier, it looks like Sourdough's finally come back to his senses. He's dressing like the old Sourdough.
Wow.
Oh, well, off-color language.
Yeah. Can't see it there. I'm going to go out and check what's going on.
Wait a second. Oh, no. They're up here.
Yeah, they're coming up this way. And sending the folks in the scouts scattered. Now he's knocked his head into the solid steps.
Oh no. Oh, he says no. They're not ready to quit, either man.
No, this is going to go on for a while. They've wrestled up here before. Karryt coming up this way.
Oh no.
Karryt.
Hey, they're a little too close here. I'm.
Now before, if Karryt was hung by this area by Jason V.
Good lord.
Right to the back.
This is too close. This is why we come up here and it's all down there.
Stone hit as the wrestlers came up here, up and over, and the match continued. Get yourself together. The wrestlers came up over the booth.
They caught me a little bit, I'm not gonna lie. Jimmy Karryt's foot caught me in the arm.
Jimmy Karryt just got caught, and he's tumbling down the stairs. The referee can't ask him because the referee can't keep up with his falling down the stairs. He didn't say no.
No, he did not say no.
He did not say I quit. And now, I don't know what's going on. I'm going to go out and check.
All right, you go check that out. I'm going to stay up here where it's nice and, well, where I thought it was nice and safe.
I'm going to take the mic with me for a second, baby. You get yourself set.
Oh, you go ahead.
And a kick to the side. Sends Karryt back toward the ring. We get back in the booth now. What we thought was the relative safety. Now just choking him with the ropes. That barrier.
What do you say, Jimmy?
This would be a submission type situation. No, he's not going to quit now. Back into the ring. And I've seen a Jason V in the past. Before he was kind of a happy-go-lucky fellow, and this type of match was right up his alley. But the current mindset of Jimmy Karryt might give him a little bit of an advantage. Now he's going to his trunks, pulling out. What is he pulling out? Oh, no, 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 no.
Oh, God.
Get that off.
Oh, he just made it back. Oh,
get
my.
Get it off.
He's got that bag that's cutting off all of his air. No, this is taking away too far.
He broke the through.
Oh.
That could have been a very bad situation.
That could have been on court TV in the near future. He's up on the top rope.
Referee throwing into the ropes. And that's a...
Oh, look, he's caught up in sort of a tree of woe type situation.
Yeah, that's not good. He's got his legs cut off. And this could very well be a submission.
His legs are cut off and the blood's running straight to his head.
He's got it cut up in the... His legs are caught up in the metal part of the turnbuckle. And really, there's no... Now, Sourdough, he's going to help out now. Get him out of there.
Oh!
Ow!
My gosh!
Why is it Sourdough helping out?
Oh, what's he going to do? I mean...
Get him out of there! Help him get his feet out. He's just... That's where the second is supposed to be. That top turnbuckle is completely loose now.
Wait a second. Oh, my gosh! Exploder dropkick from the top.
And then that knee of Jason V has gone out.
Jason V originally injured that knee a few weeks ago in tag team action against Rough Cut with Sourdough, and he did a suicide dive to the outside.
Yeah, that didn't help. I get caught up in that team buckle either. And Karryt.
I think Sourdough is not attempting to help out because Sourdough knows exactly what Jason has to do. These two have such a close relationship. They've had so many meetings in the past.
And just working on that. See, this is where you don't think wrestling plays a part in this. A match like this. Look at this. Look at this. Oh, he's got a towel. He throws in the towel. Oh, a bridge straight back.
Oh, my gosh.
Straight back. This is a version of the death block.
Look at the elevation on that bridge.
Yes, he's really got that knee bent back. He's not going to quit.
Jason V's a much stronger man than I had to quit before the bell even rang.
Breaks it off a little bit. That was a... That chops try to break that out. That was a version of a fuller leg lock.
You know, you gotta think, not only is Jimmy Karryt trying to take that leg out and re-injure that knee, but he's also taking away the main weapon of choice for Jason V, that running boot.
That is true. Now, V has a selection of submission holds. Now the chair's coming in.
Oh no!
Lining it up. Back of that knee. That's that one. Just take out the knee, but it also takes out the hamstring. Ah, that was in the calf. Oh, a little higher up.
I can't stand to watch this.
That chair. He's not going to quit. He is not going to quit. He's not going to quit.
Oh, you got to wonder, at what time is it just going to be stupid for him not to quit?
Well, it was stupid to take a match, both of them. Karryt's made some choices that were not conducive to success in some of his feuds. But no one comes out the winner in a match like this.
Jason's somehow hobbling around.
That leg,
and he's got that chair. Oh!
That took out the hand. That took out the hand. A Karryt.
Oh my, not only the hand, the fingers, the wrist, everything.
Yeah, he just rolls out. And look, I'm glad we don't have a close-up on that hand right now.
Take it from first.
Trying to knock it back into place, I think. Straight into it that time, palm first.
You heard Jason V say, if that's what you want to do, then let's do it.
Now we've got wrestlers with obvious injuries, carried with the hand and fingers, and Jason Lee still able, barely able to move off that ankle, or that knee, I should say, that was damaged earlier. I don't know how he was going to get him up there.
Right there, rolls on through.
Look at this. Now there's a submission for you. I told you he's got a few of them.
It's a scissor lock armbar combination, I call it.
Yeah. Oh, this will put out. Oh, now he's looking back on it. Oh, I don't know how he's not quitting now, but it rips out of it. Good job.
It's got to be foolish pride, is all I can say.
Desperation. Ridged out of it, and the rake to the eyes got him out. But I say that's just one of many, many submission holds that Jason B has in his arsenal.
Oh, the 540 kick!
Oh, he almost fell out of the ring. He's still hanging on there, just barely. Oh!
Oh no.
Up to the top.
Oh no, he's going for a gold digger. Gold digger from the second rope. Nope. Oh!
Oh, that's got to be it. That's his move, the gold digger.
Yeah. But.
What do you say, Jason? Do you want to quit? No.
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 What?
No.
No. No. It's very tough in an I Quit match to get someone to quit without a submission being put on them.
Garrett's searching for something now. What else could he find? All right, what is it?
That's
that box. That's the box filled with ring equipment.
Yeah, and he's loosening up the bottom rope.
He's got that tire iron trying to loosen up the turnbuckle. Oh, I don't think this is going to be good.
Well, it can't be. And he's taking a while to get that out. That's going to give Jason B a little time to recover, but... He's got a weapon, and he's making a weapon at the same time.
Come on, when can you say enough is enough here?
You sign the contract. That's what you get. And now, trying to pull it off, but he didn't quite have it ready to go.
Oh, he's going to the other side now.
He's trying to unloosen all of the bottom rope.
Jason's still out after taking that gold digger from the second rope.
Yeah. He wasn't going to quit. He's trying to pull this ring off. Now he's got a turnbuckle. No bottom rope now for all intended purposes.
Oh, no.
And he's just going to take that metal and just...
Oh, my gosh. He's digging at the face. Oh, good. Oh, come on! Somebody just quit and end this mindless violence!
No. No, he's not quitting. He's not quitting. Now, Sourdough is not throwing the towel. He's not going to quit. Stomp to the head. Now, Karryt's got to figure out something else. Now, submission wrestling is not one of Karryt's specialties.
I wouldn't even consider that submission. I would consider that maiming.
Well, maiming is a submission in this case. I mean, he's not one to do a lot of...
Ooh.
Head straight in. But again, you're doing damage. You're not... Usually, in order to get a submission, you have to have constant pain, like that move you saw with the turnbuckle, like what you're about to see with, apparently, handcuffs.
To the ring. Every time I think it can't get worse, they find a way to make me eat my words.
Now he's posing handcuffing him too. Both hands behind his back. Well, it's not going to make him quit, but it certainly makes him completely vulnerable.
Oh, good Lord.
Oh, that's that knee. Now it's... He's going to drop it. He's going to drop it.
Oh.
Oh, that's not good. And we'll take out an ACL, MCL.
Even a meniscus.
And now, trying to kick his way out.
Oh, he still has another leg. He's taking out one leg, but he's still got another.
Still trying to kick his way out. It's like, he only has two pins.
Oh!
See, if he was a real submission wrestler, a figure four would do the trick.
Oh no, he's pulling that knee pad down. The brace is off.
And he's got the chair. He's got the chair. There's really not much. He kicks it out of his hand. That's about all you can do.
Oh gosh.
Here it goes, folks. Just execution style guillotine.
You said just me?
No. It's not heavy.
You can't do it!
Somebody call Dr. Bolenbacher. Somebody call Dr. Bolenbacher. Tell him he's going to have a new patient coming up.
Wow. Ooh. Just works it straight against it.
One quick.
No! No. It's a lot of pain involved here. Folks. The referee does not have the discretion to stop this. Only if there is an I quit. Now what's he gonna do? He's gonna try something else to hit him with.
Look at Jason just trying to crawl around. He can't use his arms.
Trying to get over to get some help. And there's the cane.
Oh no.
Brought that in very early.
Singapore cane.
Brought him up against that chair, which is now set up.
You hear Jason V said, "You've done enough."
No!
Oh!
There's really no escaping at this point.
No! No!
Oh my gosh!
You want to quit? Thank you, sir.
Just set him off. He just pile driving away with that cane.
Oh, look at Shawn Rife. He's had enough.
Now, he does not have the right to do that.
No, he might. Oh my gosh!
Well, it's
Shawn Rife might not have had the right, but he's a human being, and he can see when another person's in pain. He didn't deserve that.
He broke it. He absolutely broke it.
Full on shot to the forehead, and our doctor's checking on him at ringside right now.
He's going to carve him up with that. He's going to carve him up.
Oh, no. This has gone too far. This is nuts.
Nobody to take. They need another ref. Here comes one of the refs from the back. There's nobody to take the microphone.
The other refs from the back thought he was going to be done for the night. He's going to have to come out here and... Where's Mike Underwood? He's out here somewhere.
You and I both know that's the end of it. Now say you quit. Never.
Oh God! Oh!
Right in the middle of the forehead. And it's just, it won't make any difference now if he does throw in the towel. There's nobody to take.
We've got another referee back there. Where is he? Referee, security guards, anything.
Oh, now he's going into his. A chain or something? Oh, the keys.
That's the keys. The keys of those handcuffs. He's taunting him with those keys.
Where is it?
Oh! Bringing it up between the goalposts.
The World Cup is on.
Jason trying to find a way to get out of those handcuffs.
He's almost there. He's almost there.
Oh my God, he's got one.
He's got both.
He's got them both up and looking over the corner. He's going to use them as a weapon. Oh!
Right on top of the head. Second time.
Steel colliding with the head.
Drop toe hold. Oh.
Oh my gosh, maybe a... Going for possibly a cross face with those handcuffs.
Get the microphone.
Oh, he can tap, but a tap doesn't count. He has to say the words. Here comes Mike Underwood finally. Invasion added.
We saw. No.
Oh, and he keeps saying no. Look, that added elevation. I was just talking about it.
Work on his back and neck. Yes.
No.
He's just not going to quit. This is absolutely painful.
Oh, and look, Sourdough has the keys.
Yeah, he finally has the keys. He's going to let him loose. But what type of shape is he in? His legs have taken a beating.
Oh, Sourdough, he's got one of them off. He's trying to get the other one off. Karryt's still down. Jason V is officially free.
Give me them. Oh, no.
Oh. Turn of the tables.
And it looks like he's going to try. Oh, he's just beating him with him. He just takes him in his fist and just pounding him on the head. But he's laughing. He's laughing?
I don't know anymore. Right, I don't know anymore. I thought that the Phage or the Warden was crazy, but we see Jimmy Karryt.
Duct tape. He's got duct tape.
Sooner or later, one of these two is going to have to give in.
He's got the handcuffs.
Oh, the handcuffs were fine, but this is duct tape.
Yeah, you're not going to escape from that.
He's wrangling him up, Hoss.
Get him off! I got the rope! Get him off!
It doesn't matter if he has the rope. There is no rope breaks in this match.
But they only can't break. No break. Just rolled him over.
Uh-oh.
You want to see it now? Or are you just going to give it up? Take the easy road, Karryt. Take the easy road. Give it up. Do what you want. You're going to have to kill me.
Oh, don't say that. It very well might happen.
I don't know if there's anything left.
I know the fans came here to see a good fight, but a murder is another thing.
Well, chair right to the gut.
Oh, no.
Oh! Back. I don't think Karryt is in the mind to do anything.
Oh, he's got him begging. I don't think I've ever heard Jimmy Karryt beg before.
Into the gut.
Oh!
This is long, long gone by beyond sport.
We say,
no. He has lost his mind. He has absolutely lost his mind.
I think he lost his mind a long time ago.
You have to be in the mindset. Going to do it. I don't think the pain is going to make any difference.
This is where the powder keg is taking over. He's going for that boot. Oh, there it is!
He's out, but he can't say anything.
What do you say, Jimmy?
He's asleep.
Oh, he's out.
You can't knock the guy out.
Doctor going to be checking on him, making sure he's okay. There's no head injury or anything.
He didn't quit.
Oh, he's got to pour water on him.
Revive him.
He's got to be choking some of that water.
Somebody's got to do something.
What is it going to take?
loading that boot one more time.
You both have proved your point. What? How much further does it have to go?
He's walking right into it.
Well, what's he gonna do?
Do it.
He can't block. His arms are duct taped behind him. It's over. Thank goodness this is mercifully over.
I said you are a sick, sick man. I told you that I knew you better than you knew yourself. You booted me. You booted me with my hands behind my back, completely defenseless. Simply proved my point. Now.
He certainly lost his mind, has Karryt.
Yeah, I want to show you something, dude. I want to prove to you exactly what kind of man you are. You're here. You did everything you said you were going to do. You gave me that boot. You were wired enough to do it again. So do it.
Oh, wait a second.
Go ahead.
Wait a second. See him do it again. He's challenging him. He's loading it up. Oh, he wants to. He really wants to. And he's not going to do it. Oh, it's spit in the face. He's just trying to taunt him. Oh, goes in the face of. Now he's gone nuts. Now he's really lost it.
You are the vicious side! My God, you are the vicious side!
Oh, man. Man, this is not good, folks. The crowd is absolutely stunned silent. Absolutely stunned silent. The winner is Jason B., but... what has he lost? What has he lost?